Today I'm going to show you simple steps to make awesome articulated keychains using Tinkercad, so let's get cracking. Before we start, friends, I do want to let you know this is built on the bundle group technique. This is a fun little flexi snake with this mechanism right here that prints in place so that when you're done, it flexes. If you have not seen this tutorial, you can use the bit.ly right here or check the cards of this video to learn the skill. For this project, though, we're going to start from scratch. If you've never been in Tinkercad before, you can get there by visiting tinkercad.com. I always choose sign in with Google. Today, we're going to hit create brand new 3D design. Let's start by naming it, and we are going to name this Flexi Name. Notice when you click down here, your project is actually saved. I'm going to bring out the word text just so you can see how this works. If you back out to the Tinkercad workspace, that design is instantly saved. And if you want to get back into it, you simply click Tinker This. Everything is saved to the cloud when you use Tinkercad. All right, let's start here by getting our font. I'm going to build with the multi-language font. I'm going to just do capital letters. You do want to stick to those. And I'm going to use the word lions. I like this because it demonstrates what we do when we have letters that do not have a good connection area. And you'll see that the system I've got is pretty slick. We are going to build our Flexi system today with the torus. Now we want one standing up and we want one laying down. Of course, laying down is super simple. Notice it fits in a 20 by 20 grid. That would be a radius of 10. Well, check it out. If you add the radius plus the tube, that is the 10, which gives you a diameter of 20. Now the number that we want is 3. And then we also need one of these vertical. Now we could rotate this one, but instead I'm going to do this, where I bring it out on a flat spot. I'm gonna put that number 3 and press enter. And then I'm gonna click down here to get rid of the living work plane and hit D to drop. So these are the two parts that we're gonna use to connect everything together. Now for easy printing, we need this one to be flattened on the bottom. So I'm just gonna bring out the whole cube. I'm gonna set the height to 1 and press enter. And then when we bring this underneath that shape, I'm gonna shrink it closer to the correct size. Doesn't have to be perfect, but it also doesn't have to be that big either, and do Control G to union group. That's floating, but we can fix that by hitting D to drop. Now this one needs to be tilted. The number of degrees I'm gonna tell you is 25. Simply move it to whatever number you want and then type it in the box. I'm doing negative 25 for the way I've got it rotated right now. And then I'm gonna hit D to drop so that that's at the correct height. Those two link inside each other. We'll line them up in a minute. Now, instead of trimming this one so it's flat, we're going to bring out a support. Simply grab the pyramid and then do shift shrink. And I'm going to go all the way down to size 3. I'm going to make it wider and then just slide it into that area. Let's select all of that and do L for align. And it doesn't matter which one you pick. We want it to be centered. I'm going to make sure the point is below. But you can see that is now a nice base for that print to start. And if you check quickly, there is a gap all the way around for the two pieces. And I'm just going to stay with that gap right there. Now we're going to use this to connect all these letters. Even though right now they're one piece, when we print it, they will all be separate. But they will be linked with these. And we're going to create an awesome bundle group using the half sphere that cuts out the area so these actually still flex. Let's do shift squeeze and get this down to size 5. I'm going to move it into this place and make it a hole. Now we want it to be less than this piece right here. And we want it to be into this piece one click. I'm going to switch my nudge to 0.25. And I just want to make sure that I don't cut into that piece. Let's do a quick bit of alignment. I'm going to shift select the hole and the blue one, choose L for align, and we want it to be in the center. Now I'm going to just grab this and I'm going to come out at least 1 millimeter, maybe 2, and the same way over here, 1, maybe 2. So I'm just making sure I've got area to the left and the right so that this has space, and I'm making sure that this is going to cut out. Now here's where it gets magical. Grab all of these and do Control B to make a bundle group. What this means is these are all stuck together, but they cannot cut each other. This hole will cut whatever it touches, but it won't cut these parts. Let me show you why that's cool. Control D, move this over in between the S and the N. We just want to make sure that this tube right here connects and this tube right here connects. We don't want this piece to run into that piece. With that link in place, let's do Control D and Shift Nudge to get one between the N and the O. We can easily hit F for fit view and then just use the arrow keys to nudge it once again, making sure that there's a gap at that spot. If I do Control D again and Shift Nudge to move this one over, once again, F for fit view is super slick. Get it lined up so you've got that gap again, and then do Control D again. And then this one's going to be a little tricky. I'm going to just get it on this side like it would be. So right there it's sticking in. But then over here, there's nothing to connect to on an L. So what we're going to do is build an extra part. Simply bring out a cube. And then we're going to type these numbers. I'm going to tell you a radius of 3. I'm going to tell you steps of 10. A length of 6. We're going to stay with the width of 20 and a height of 3. I have found that these blend in here pretty well. And we just slide it in place like that, and it'll connect to the L. It's the best solution I've found yet for letters that have dangling parts. Notice this one sticks through a little bit too far, so then we simply go back here and change the size. I do want to save this for later, so I'm going to do Control D and set it up there. Instead of 20, I'm going to just back this up to 15 and nudge it into place. Finally, let's wrap up with a connector for our keychain. Once again, Control D to nudge that down. I'm going to have it connect right here. That means I need to make this even smaller. Let's go 10. And of course, nudge it into place. And then I'm going to use the tube for the keychain connector. Radius of 6. Wall thickness of 2.5. I'm going to do a bevel of 2 and segments of 10. And then I want a height of 4 and press enter. Bring that into place. Once again, making sure there's a gap between that. And friends, right there is your keychain. I'm going to select them all and do L for a line. Pick the word and make sure I've got them all centered. Now, as I look at this, there is one piece that sticks out. Let me show you how we'd fix that. A couple of steps. One, work plane and set it on this edge so we can trim. Two, bring out a whole cube and set it on that work plane. Three, hide this part. Now we want to keep this together, but we've got to ungroup it for now. And we're just going to use the arrow keys to get so we can cut this off. Shift select, Control G to group. So that is now cut. Once again, we're going to grab all these and do Control B to put them back into a bundle group. And now when we do show all and put our work plane back down on the ground, that'll once again do the cool trim, but it doesn't have the part sticking out. Depending on your word, you may have to do those kind of steps more than once. Now we can grab everything, and instead of a bundle group, we're gonna do Control G to do a union group. You'll see all these little red lines as Tinkercad is calculating. This does take a little bit more effort for Tinkercad, but after it completes, you can see it has cut out the area. This is a cool example. If I hit T for transparent, check it out. That ring is totally independent of the other. So when this finishes printing, you'll have a wicked cool flexi chain with whatever word you've chosen. I'm going to hit T to make it back to a solid just because I like that look. And let's do export as an STL. And I'm going to save it in my 3D modeling folder as Lions Flexi Keychain and hit save. Of course, now we can bounce to Bambu Lab Studio. Let's hit add. There is my Lions Flexi Keychain. I have got a blue loaded. We're going to do 0.24 millimeter draft. Let's slice that plate. It's going to take about 24 minutes, and let's print that plate. And less than 30 minutes later, we have got a fantastic Flexi Keychain with whatever word you want. I do want you to know, I also did it with the snake connector. It does not wiggle as much with the snake connector, so you can pick whichever kind you want. I also want to highlight that on Friday, we're going to do it with custom fonts. And this one is using the method we made today, and it also is multicolor. How cool is that? So let's quickly wrap up. Once again, we used the awesome bundle group, where parts that are bundled can't cut each other. That allowed us to make an area that cut out where the Flexi was going to be, making the whole process so much slicker. Don't forget Friday, we're going to have another video that shows how to use custom fonts and even shows how to make them multicolor. I do want to give a quick shout out to all of my YouTube members. Of course, there are three different levels of support, starting as low as $5 a month. And with any level of support, you get early access to videos. I also want to say thank you to everybody that supports me via Patreon. Love how that group is growing. It has got more than 225 members. There is a fantastic messaging area that you can even use for free. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.